I would now like to call upon the great trustee, Chris Rainey, who will read greetings from when you were able to see all three boards of your accomplishments over the last 3 years. Your classes excelled academically, athletically, artistically, and your work in the community has been done in the spirit of giving that has contributed greatly to the betterment of your community. So be proud of what you've accomplished. 35 years ago, I was sitting where you're sitting now. I may or may not have gone to college. I may or may not have worn an AI t-shirt. I liked that being in SoCal, California, playing on my Sony Walkman. And I was absolutely certain that the Toronto Maple Leafs would win the Stanley Cup. I was wrong about it so much. But one thing I was right about was my absolute belief. Instilled by my teachers and by my family as well, that I should aim for the stars. Full understanding that a lot of time I was living in the shadows, and that the things I learned were important and to use. I know this sounds trite and simple, but I assure you it's not. If at all that teaches you anything, it's that a lot of people make unhappy choices for themselves, and you don't have to do that. You may have to make sacrifices that you'll have to make in your life, but never, ever let those sacrifices be your happiness. You also need to embrace failure. No matter what you do moving forward, you're going to fail at something. Students fail, politicians fail, sales teams fail, sports teams fail. The reality is, if you're good at what you do, you're going to fail, because it means that you're out there taking risks. Failing isn't a bad thing, it's the fear of failing that messes everything up. Let me share this parable with you. It's an old Cherokee chief was teaching his grandson about life. A fight was going on inside of him, and said to the boy, "It's a terrible fight, and it's between two wolves. One is evil, he's angry, envy, sorrow, regret, greed, arrogance, self-hate, guilt, resentment, inferiority, lies, and false pride. The other is good, he's joy, peace, love, hope, serenity, humility, kindness, benevolence, empathy, generosity, compassion, and faith. The same fight is going on inside of you and every other person too." The grandson thought about it for a minute and asked his grandfather, "Which wolf will win?" The old chief simply replied, "The one you feed." So graduating class of 2018, the world we're joining desperately needs your help. Our governments are broken, divided by partisanship. Our cities are war zones, our farms and family businesses are disappearing. More people can vote a Kardashian than they can sign them. And yet, so much wrong in the world, there's hope. And that hope is you. While some of you may seek to tackle big problems that our society faces, it is just as important that all of you realize that small actions make big differences. When your choices are based on thoughtfulness, kindness, integrity, you're building a better world. Take what a wonderful school that this is and what Dunbarton has taught you and bring it into the world. The world needs it and the world needs you. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Brady. I have this image of you with the mullet now burned into my head. So thank you for that. And now I'd like to call upon our honored principal, Ms. Cecilia Sharp.
This afternoon, you are among loved ones. You are among friends. You are among people who care. There is no greater gathering than this one today. This is a very special moment in time. Trustee Chris Brady, Superintendent distinguished guests, the Dunbarton High School staff, family and friends of the graduates, ladies and gentlemen of the Dunbarton class of 2018. I'm honored and privileged to have this opportunity to speak with you this afternoon. We have gathered here for a very special and important reason, to celebrate the academic accomplishments of these fine young ladies and gentlemen after many years of focus and dedication. This is a moment that will not eager to embrace the next steps that will lead them yet further down the road of their own very personal journey. In the background, behind these smiling faces of our graduating class, are the beaming silhouettes of the many proud parents and family members, friends, teachers, school support staff, who all take great pleasure in being here today and taking part in this wonderful event. It is at this moment that I would like to address our graduating students. I would ask that you take a moment to reflect on these very special people seated behind you, all dressed up for this special occasion, boys with cameras, ready to snap the minute you walk onto the stage. These are the amazing and incredible people in your life. Who? And the list is long, so very long. Encouraged, supported, assisted, listened, comforted, advised time in and time out, drove to practices, came out to games, theatrical performances, art shows, music recitals, supported fundraisers, attended school meetings, paid for the field trips, jerseys, yearbooks, bought for you, for school board, binders, cell phones, computers, computer paper, and even the game. Picked up the homework. Dropped off your friends' house to drove you and your friends to the mall, and so much more. Then they did it all again, year after year, with a smile on their lips and love in their eyes, more often than not, and expecting only in return that you work harder to raise and take out the garbage on Tuesdays. Now, you are one of those rather rare individuals who, upon reflection, is thinking, but this is sharp. These people you speak of love doing all these things for me. They would be bored out of their minds if they didn't have something to do. Looking after me helped keep them sane. It gets them up and out of the house, not counting going to work, of course. I would suggest to you that shortly after this ceremony is done, you ask the question of why. Why did you do all of this for me? I do believe the answer will be quite evident the moment you look into their eyes. They won't have to say a word, not even one. Now, some of you may be thinking, where's the principal going with this speech? Shouldn't she be talking about us, our hard work, commitment, accomplishments that all brought us here today? Of course, all in good time. My speech is a tad long, so I ask you to bear with me. Including my own children, I say this to them all the time. No, I'm not quite done yet. So I have a little bit more to say. So pull up a chair and make yourself comfortable. These very special and important people are behind each and every one of you today, as they have done so over all these years. They are here today, there for you tomorrow and throughout your life. No one is silent, and our success is not only possible because of those who support and encourage us to forge on in spite of the many obstacles we often face. One only has to take the time to listen to the story of any one person's life, and you will find that no one's life is a walk in the park. There are so many facets, with some facing more challenges than others. But it is what you decide to make it. And it is at these difficult times that loved ones come forward to fortify your inner strength. Undoubtedly, they will continue to be there throughout your life. Through the example of the late Stephen Hawking, a brilliant physicist who had made groundbreaking discoveries regarding the cosmos, black holes, and other unexplored aspects of the universe we live in, and who knew only too well what it meant to face apparently insurmountable challenges. At the age of 21, he was told that he had motor neuron disease and had only 2.5 years to live. His life is an astonishing story of a resilient man who faced enormous odds and went on to become one of the world's most famous scientists due to his work in theoretical physics, made possible because of a brilliant mind, but also because of the unlimited support from descent. You are here today because of all of your consistent efforts and hard work. You should now know that you have the strength and fortitude to continue on this journey because of your very fire and makeup to succeed, but also because of the unconditional love and support which your family and friends continue to give as they have done over all these years. As you take the next steps in your journey, you will be making choices all along the way. In living our lives, we have all had choices presented to us and decisions to make. Just take a moment to listen to a grandparent, a parent, a trusted friend. If you hear their stories, you will clearly see that they have had to make many decisions throughout their lives, some more difficult than others. You too will have many choices and decisions to make as you move through time. They will be yours to make. Make them without fear. Don't live your life by what other people think, and don't let your inner voice be drowned out by the voice and the noise of others. Seek advice from those you trust, but always remember that yours is the final word. Live your life with passion in how you live and in what you do. The work you choose will fill a large part of your life, and how you do that work will help to define who you are. Do it like no one else has ever done. Take pride in what you do. But most importantly, love what you do. And only then will people notice. At this time in your life, you may not be certain that you have. If this is the case, keep searching and don't settle. Follow your dreams. It sounds so simple. And in fact, at times, there will be obstacles along the way. At times, it may even seem easier to just let your dreams go and settle for less. In times like this, pause, breathe slowly, reflect, grow out a lifeline for support, be true to yourself, then hold on to those dreams. In the words of writer Nancy Sins, don't dismiss your dreams. To be without dreams is to be without hope. To be without hope is to be without purpose. The time has come for you to write the next chapter in your journey. Choose your own adventure and follow your dreams. So whatever you plan to do, whether you plan to travel the world, continue on in school, join the workforce, or take some time off to make a plan, don't just listen to your head. Listen to your heart and follow those dreams. Today is a day of celebration, but it is also a day to embrace a challenge. Look back with pride at all that you've accomplished. Look to the future with confidence, knowing that you will be going forward to use all of your talents, abilities, creativity, and energy in finding a way to give service to others. Do all that you can in making this world a better place to live. If you endeavor to follow this road, you will have chosen for yourself a very meaningful life, and you will love the wonderful moments it will bring. It will be a life rich in experiences and full with accomplishments, and you will have touched the lives of so many in ways you can't begin to imagine. Most of all, be happy. Your future awaits you. From all of us here today, we love you, and from us here today, care deeply. Congratulations to the Dunbarton graduating class of 2018.
Thanks so much, Ms. Sharp, for that inspiring message. We are now ready to begin the presentation of the awards of the station. These awards acknowledge student achievement in a variety of areas, academics, citizenship, and involvement in extracurricular activities. Mr. Hugh Mowbray will be reading the names of the awards of the station recipients, and these awards will be presented by various donors from the community as well as Dunbarton staff. I would also like to remind graduates and their families to please remain seated until the conclusion of the ceremony. Families, please refer to your program for a complete list of the awards of the station and honor our beloved graduates.
Thank you. The Austin Administratorial Leadership Award will be presented by Aisha Hathaway. This award goes to a student who is actively involved in the school community and is a dedicated volunteer. This year's recipient is Aaron Brady.
Beginning with Jay Davis. Cheyenne Grant.
And Nadia Beltaya.
This year's award winner is Gregory Chapman.
This year's supported the graduates of the class of love and dedication baseball and softball, and is pursuing dual secondary studies. Congratulations, Matthew McKinney.
We have an award, the Pickering Graduate Film Club Memorial Bursary.
Mark Durham. Our next two presenters will be Mr. Mike Smith and Ms. Laura Sullivan. This is the Ricardo Rivera Language and Human Studies Award. It's awarded to an outstanding grade 12 French student. We have two recipients. That will preside.
Standards and initiative, and exceeds expectations in
Daniel will be presenting technological learning and instruction. This is where the student demonstrated the greatest commitment to skill development and leadership in the instruction program, and is pursuing a career in the construction trades. Congratulations, Tyler Jones. Mr. McFadden will be presenting technological learning and transportation. This is where the student will demonstrate the greatest commitment to skill development and leadership in the transportation program and is pursuing a career in the transportation trade. Congratulations, Wade.
Thank you.
thanks to staff and administration for doing all the behind the scenes work that goes for EHS running so smoothly. Thanks to teachers who really stepped up for EHS students from the top class, figuring out how we can be the core thing for our online vital connection. Thanks to our friends.
Because that's what you do from life.
We didn't know what Santa Claus was doing, so we marched out of the North Pole very quickly. And we certainly didn't know what Mr. Pendle's obsession with polar bears was all about.
Diploma to be attending Trent University to study nursing.
Todd, who will be attending UOIT in 7 years.
Thank you.
Durham High School will attend Durham University to study interactive arts and science. Daniel Mupaw will be attending Durham University to study global health. Graham Nessel will be attending Durham University to study bachelor's sport management. Liam Mupaw will be attending Central College to study fire protection engineering. Christina LaVera will be attending Durham Brown College to study child and youth care. Colson Patton will be receiving an SHS diploma, will be attending UOIT to study bachelor's honors in government and commerce. Isabella Roder will be attending Durham University to study screenwriting. Rosie McCarr will be attending University of Toronto to study life sciences. Thank you, Ms. Sharp. At this point, I'd like to call upon Mr. Richard McNally to study, to continue the presentation of the moment. Catherine Boston will be attending a master's in life science. Bethany Brown will receive an SHS diploma, will be attending the University of Ottawa to study political science and studies French version. Robert Brown will be attending the Master University to study business. Gina Dossel will be attending the Queen's University to study current education. Matthew McKittrick will be attending Durham College to study sports management. Summer Jenny will be attending the University of Waterloo to study political science and business. Chloe Carolina will be attending Waterloo University to study mathematics and chartered professional accounting. Brian Cook will be receiving an SHS diploma and will be attending Durham College to study trades and rules. Matthew Berger will be receiving an SHS diploma and will be attending friendship of. Thank you. And as Rossi, we can thank you for so well today for your time. Shreya Aslan, we can thank you for your Christian today, social work. Joshua Oshra, we are thank you for your PHS.
Thank you.
Nigel Bobby will be attending Durham College to take this. Charlene Howell will be attending Senate Fest and President Hurst. Emily Hurst will be attending Wolfpack University to take Fine Arts. Michael Crusoe will be attending to teach us. Aaron Chambers will be attending Durham College to take the year program. Troy Chambers will be attending BC University to study political science, philosophy, and economics. Gerald Charles will be attending Bryson University to study retail management. Maria Chakri will be attending UOT to study social sciences and humanities. Sinara Chakri will be attending University of Toronto to study history.
Thank you. question. I